Hello guys, welcome to this MySQL upgrade presentation. My name is Luis. I'm Oracle Database. My background is so DBA, Oracle DBA. Why I present you this MySQL upgrade? Well, because a few months ago, just at the starting of the pandemic situation, so I start to working with Actito, that is a online marketing company. This company use MySQL, okay, as a storage engines. So I switch from Oracle Database Administration to MySQL, and one of the first tasks they ask me to achieve is upgrading the version of MySQL they had to the new version we have now. So we start from 5.6, and now we have 8.0.19, and we plan to move to 8.0.23 in a few weeks, maybe. So I will present you the index. So the index is a landing in the world MySQL. As I said, I was Oracle DBA, so I land. In the second part, we will see the prerequisite needed to achieve a good upgrade. Then we will see the upgrade methods chosen. You will see that there is a few ones, two in particular, so we choose one of them. Then we make some tests and we upgrade. And in the conclusion, we will see some new features of MySQL 8. So get ready, we go. So landing in the MySQL world. Okay. So for me it was not very easy at the just beginning because of the background essentially. But very rapidly I discovered some very good news. When you need to administrate the MySQL database, for example, well, we will see in the presentation. But for example, the possibility to have the source database and the replica with a different version. So it's very agile and good features. So when I land to this world and with the objective to make the migration, the first thing we can see in this slide is okay, I googled for the information. So I found two methods, basically, that everyone knows this method is MySQL dump method, that consists in take a MySQL dump of all the database and contents of the database table, users, grant, and so on. And this process generate a file, a flat file that you can edit and see the content. And this file can be restored, so loaded in the new server with the version you want. Okay, so it works. But in our case, we have a 4 terabytes database for each server, and we have six principal servers. So it was approximately 30 hours each one of downtime. Okay so the problem is that marketing online marketing company, you know what it means. It means that some customer can for example execute some email campaigns at every hours and every day of the week, so we don't have the weekend as a downtime. Okay, we don't have this this opportunity, so we need to find another methods very rapid. So I continue looking for this, and I saw the in-place upgrade, and the in-place upgrade in our case the downtime was just 2 hours, so it was good for us. Okay, so I give you here the documentation, the official documentation of upgrading a database, okay? And I just copy this important information in the screen. It's just to sensibilize the people to read the documentation, because at the top of the documentation you have this stick important that explain that the downgrade from 8 to 5.7 or 8 release to a previous is not supported. So okay, you need to read the documentation. So it's not an option. You need to make it, and you will see that if you read the documentation and you achieve correctly all the prerequisites, the upgrade in itself, it's not very complicated. Okay, even if you never touch it, as it was my case. So this is the documentation. Okay, you have the official documentation, but I don't. So I read it, but I don't use it to migrate to make the migration. I use another source of information that is a blog of Frédéric Deschamps that is present in this conference. He helped me a lot with all the process, so he gave me this. This URL that is his blog, and it's a condensed, it's a sum up of all the documentation we can find in the official website, but it's very step by step, very summarized. And for me, it was very easy to use because it's, you know, I assume that he make a lot of upgrades, a lot of situations. So this blog is really very very cool because it's very small, very 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 well explained, and in fact I use it to make the migration, so you can make the same. So as a prerequisite, we have the first thing you need to have is a flight plan. Okay, you can't take off without a heading, so you need to have a flight plan. And in our case, we decide to make this schema. For example, you have the source DB at versions 5.6, and we have one replica database. So we create a second replica with the same version at the beginning. Okay. So the photo is this one. We have two servers, and now we have three servers. One is a source and two replicas. Okay. Why two replicas? Because one of the first most important requisite you need before making this is to have a good backup. You can't, it's like, I don't know, jump out of a plane without a parachute. You died, okay? It's obvious. So make an upgrade without a good backup, it's not a very good idea. So in our case, as we have the 5.6 and we don't have the new, I speak about this later, but the new shell dump utility, that is a very very nice tool to make backups. For example, we don't have it with this version, so we decide, taking as consideration the size of our database, 4 TB each one, 6 servers. We decide to create a second replica, synchronize it, and don't touch it. Just keep this server as rollback server if something goes wrong. Okay. So the first step we done is to upgrade one of the replicas. You see, replica one now is 8.0.19 version. Okay. So I give you in this slide just the super tool shell that you need to have installed. It's a requisite, mandatory requisite. So you to have it. You just yum configure, you enable the MySQL 8 community source, and you yum install MySQL shell, and it's okay. Take the last version. It's a recommendation made by MySQL, and even if you are going to migrate 8.0.19, get in my case I get the 8.0.23 version of MySQL shell. Okay. Okay, so the day The day of the upgrade, we have other requisites that are listed here. For example, have a good internet connection and root access. It's obvious. And the shell, it's another requisite. We talk about the flight plan. We talk about the backup, and now we talk about this check before upgrade. If you take a look to the documentation, you will see a lot of steps. I remember it's about 20 or something like that, 20, 22 steps to check before I make the upgrade. Okay, so in the past, you have to make this query one by one. Okay, this shell, this utility of the shell, make all the stuff for you in one shot. It's very, very cool because you don't have to think a lot of maybe I forgot a step. I don't know. No. You just execute this command and you have a report at the end. And if the report is zero error, so you have green light and you can make the upgrade. Okay. So the command is very easy. You connect to the shell. You use the util. Your routine, you call the check for server upgrade plugin, and you connect to the database. In this case, I was in local server. Okay, you give the path of the config file, and you redirect the output to the file, to tmp upgrade.log, just to have a file to check left later. Okay, so in the URL I put just at the end of this slide, you have all the steps that this upgrade plugin will do for you. But if you want to make it yourself, you can select query, you can execute them, and it's not a problem. Okay, and the backup. Okay, never ever start an upgrade without a good backup. In our case, it was a replica too. See, if you have a little database and you have a it's not a problem for you to make a dump, so make a dump. If you want to clone a VM, clone the VM, everything you want, but you need to have a backup. A tested backup. Okay, it's not enough to make a backup. You need to restore this backup to see if this backup is nice. Okay, I saw in the past with Oracle a site where they have backups, okay, but they were corrupt and they never restored these backups. And the day they lost the data, they saw that the backup was corrupted and they can't get the data back. So it was a very, very, very awful situation. Okay, so make a backup, restore it, and it's okay. So the upgrade method chosen. As I explained at the beginning of this presentation, I saw MySQL dump, but that is very easy. You get the DB, it creates a file, and the file is played on the destination. That is okay. In the file, you have create database, create table, blah blah blah, and you have all the database, all the tables, all the structure, the data, all is in this file, okay? But in our case, it was not good because 30 hours of downtime is not acceptable. So we decide to check the other one, that is the in-place database, the in-place upgrade, sorry. So it's good because it just modifies the binaries. And in this case, the catalog, because the catalog from 5.6 to 8 is very, very different. So this was a big step of the upgrade, but basically in this case you just adapt the repository. You don't have any data to move, so the procedure is very, very clean and very rapid. Okay, testing. Okay, it was a very, very important step. Why? Because in these steps we saw some errors that we don't want to face the day of the real upgrade with the production environment. So to test, we have three servers in test as production with same OS, same data, same version, same network. The only thing we have here different was the disk, the quality of the disk. Okay, production is SSD, and this test machine was RPM 7200 RPM disk, old disk. Okay. So the difference is the upgrade was longer. Okay, but it's not an issue for me because we know that SSD was is more rapid, so no problem. Okay. So the test. During the test, we need some. We found some issue to be fixed before. For example, we have some views that have a wrong referent. Okay. So it was just alter the view, put the good referent on it, and the check just stopped to cry with this error. All this error, I saw them with the shell check upgrade tool that I mentioned just before. Okay. So after fixing the views, we saw some parameters that are not supported in MySQL 8. For example, the query cache. We have three parameters of query cache, and in the report at the end, you see errors. And if you take a look of the detail of the error, you see explicitly what is going on. So in my case, I saw that effectively I have three parameters that I just need to remove from the init file. Okay. And we also have, well, it's not in this slide, but I can mention it. We saw some issue with the MySAM engine. Okay, MySQL 8 I don't know if MySQL 8 don't support it. Oh yes, maybe Frédéric can explain this better later. But in the test, if you have a MySQL table, the test raise an error, so you can't make the upgrade with errors in the report. Okay, so in my case, I just alter the tables, a few tables to InnoDB, and it was fixed. And we have an issue with the Puppet config. Why? Because we have a cron tab with a script that is executed every 5 minutes and make a Puppet apply. Puppet apply takes the init file from MySQL from the repo and put it in the server. So the first time I make it this upgrade, the upgrade crash because of this. Okay, so we just comment the line in the cron tab, Puppet stop working, and then the upgrade was okay. All right. I make it three times, because the first one I make it myself, the second one I make it with different people that are not DBA, so just to see if the documentation was enough clear for everyone, and the last time I don't upgrade myself, but another people upgrade with the documentation. Okay, it's just to see if the documentation is clear. Okay. So the upgrade, very easy. When you make all the steps I just mentioned before, the upgrade itself is not a pain, because you have an upgrade, you have make the checks, you fix all the errors. Okay, you need just to schedule the upgrade and make it. Okay, so I tell here that thanks to MySQL flexibility, we were able to migrate first the replica 1 and that get synchro between the source and the replica. Okay, and once all the replica were upgraded, then we plan to upgrade the production server with downtime. So the day we make the upgrade, we just check that is no application connection. The synchro is okay between all the source and the replica. We run the shell script check in the production server, just in case. We upgrade, we restart the application, and test all the modules of the application. Important tip here is to use a Tmux or screen when you execute the real upgrade in production, because we don't know if you have a VPN disconnection or maybe a connection problem or some issues with the screen or Temux, you have the process running on in background and it's okay. All right? And the conclusion is very easy for me. It was MySQL is another world. No problem to say this because I see that we have a lot of very good tools, a good flexibility, and the documentation is very clear. We have a good team in the Slack canal, for example, for help. It's very dynamic. Well, so the good news for all people is the simplicity of the process. So you need to prepare very well this upgrade, but once you have the flight plan, the upgrade is not a pain, is what I said just before. And you will enjoy a new a lot of new features, new plugins like replica sets, clone, and so on. So we are going to see some example here. For example, the clone option. Wow, this is a very nice option. Because in our case, we don't use the GTID for the source and replica technology, you know. We use the most older technology. So with the clone, you can create a replica with just executing these few steps. You install the clone in master and replica. You set the clone valid donor list. The source IP here is the IP of the source database where you are going to point to grab the data, and then you clone the instance. Boom. At the end of the cloning, from the slave, you select a bin log and bin log position from the clone status, and you change master with the data you have with the result of the previous query, okay? And you start the slave, and it's done. It's very easy. So I clone 450 gigabyte in 80 minutes. It's very good. Okay? Shell dump for backup. I already said the backup is another world now with this shell. You can see the official documentation clicking in this link, but I can explain a little bit. So you have three main options. You can dump an instance, a schema, or tables. Okay. So I tried the backup shell with a 4 terabyte instance, and I was able to copy it in 2 hours. So you can manage the quantity of threads you want for parallelism. You can manage the compression and so on. Okay, it's very very good. So previously with MySQL dump, the same database was backup was with about 10 hours. So you see the ratio. There is no color. Okay, just try it. I tried inclusive to restore a database from a backup. Easy. Okay, it's very very easy. Shell plugins. This is a wonderful features of MySQL 8. Why? Because you can use a lot of plugins already created. So I give you here some documentations and Frederic's repository where he have a lot of shell plugins. Okay, that you can use. For example, if you are if you're interested of about performance, you have a lot of plugins that can detect, for example, slow queries, index, full table scan queries, locks, and so on. It's very, very nice, and it go deep. If for example, you get a lock, you put the ID of the lock, and it will tell you exactly what is going on under this. So it's very nice. And I put a demo that is a YouTube link that you will see Frédéric playing with some plugins. So you are going to see, yes, it's very easy. It's Python. So if you want to create yours, you can. It's open. And in the document, in the le documentation of Frédéric, you have a documentation on how to create your own plugins too. Okay. And that's all. Thank you for your attention. I hope this presentation helped you to decide to move to MySQLite. I was a newbie, and I achieved this with no complication. So bye bye. See you in another performance like this one. Bye bye. Ciao.